To start our brand new series, but we'll get more into that later. I have two announcements for you guys. Are you ready? First one is that we have Wednesday night services that started back up again here at the church. You don't need to sign up at all. Just come, make sure you wear your mask, and we will have a class for you, and it's so exciting. My second announcement is what I'm most excited about. Harvest Festival is coming right around the corner on October 31st. It's on a Sunday this year, guys. It's between 5 and 8. Show up in your most awesomest costumes. Not too scary, because I get scared very easily. But show up, and I'm so excited to have fun with you guys, okay? So let's get ready for today's service and for worship, okay? Let's pray. Jesus, thank you so much for bringing us all here today to just worship you, God, and learn more about you and learn all of the beautiful and amazing things that you have planned for us today, God. I pray that you will just teach these kids and teach us, even as the teachers, more about you and just how amazing and great you are. We thank you and we praise you, and we are so blessed to have to spend this awesome day with you, God. Thank you and we praise you. Amen. Amen. Let's get ready for worship.
I've got joy down in my soul. I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Joy down in my soul to stay. And nothing's gonna take it away. Joy down in my soul. I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Whatever comes my way, I'll be okay.
Cause I've got joy.
When things don't go my way, still my joy can stay. Cause you give me blessings every day. I've got joy down in my soul. I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Joy down in my soul to stay. And nothing's gonna take it away. Joy down in my soul. I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Whatever comes my way, I'll be okay.
Cause I've got joy.
Ooh, I've got joy. You fill my heart with hope. You're everywhere I go. So even if I'm feeling
gonna take it away. Joy down in my soul. I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Whatever comes my way, I'll be okay. Sunrise, gonna fix my eyes on the one who never fails. I'm gonna make some noise, cause you give me joy, and it's never ever going away. Every new sunrise, gonna fix my eyes on the one who never fails. I'm gonna make some noise, cause you give me joy, and it's never ever going away. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Cause I've got joy.
to our new series called Big and Small. You get it, Misana?
Big and small.
I think big we all get it, Miss Ryan.
So, in this series, we're gonna talk about a lot of big things, and we're gonna talk about a lot of small things. Like, what do you prefer better, big or small?
Well, I don't know, it depends. I like some things to be big, but some things I would prefer them to be small.
Like, what about a piece of cake? What would you prefer?
Ooh, a really big piece, like the whole cake, if I could. But if it came down to pieces, like a really big piece.
That's good. And what about a test?
A very, very small test. Like spelling tests, I'm really bad at spelling, so like three questions, that's it. That's all I can do.
I'd rather do one.
That's true. Only one would be better.
Yeah. Well, those are good things, right? Big
yes.
and small things to have.
Mm-hmm.
But also like feeling big or small, right?
Ooh, yeah.
Like say when you're in fifth grade, how did you feel?
I felt so big, Miss Anna, because as a fifth grader, I would help the kindergartners get to the bus because I was one of the big kids. So I felt big when I was in fifth grade.
Now, what happened when you got to sixth grade? Did you feel big then?
No, I felt kind of small because there was two other bigger grades. There was the seventh grade and the eighth grade, and they were so much bigger than I was.
That's so true. So it does,
yeah.
It does mix depending on the question, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So with this series, we have our big idea.
Big idea.
Yes, but instead of calling it a big idea, I think we should call it a really big idea.
Really big, huge idea.
Yes. This helps us understand what the lesson is going to be about.
Yes.
Yes. So it's somewhere around here, but I don't know where it is.
Got it.
But okay.
It says it's a big idea, but it's so small. It's
now
like
you need
really
something
small.
Then to help you see that.
Oh, that's why this is here.
Oh. Okay. Okay, let's read it.
Okay. We are small, but God is big.
I love that big idea. Really big idea.
Really big idea.
So sometimes we feel big and sometimes we feel small.
Yeah.
But did you know that we're really small compared to God?
That's true.
Yes, so we've been wondering what Carl's been up to. Have you been seeing his videos?
I missed Carl. I have no idea where he went. I think he went on like vacation or something.
Yes, well, we're gonna see what he was actually been up to. So let's go check out Carl.
Hi there, kids. It's so good to see y'all. Isn't it just a wonderful day? Now, I spent all weekend studying for this week's episode. I just got so excited, I ran out of time. So I have one more video to study. Will you watch it with me? Awesome. Now this video apparently shows us how big this universe is, but it can't be that big, right? But I guess we'll see. Roll the clip! So that's Earth. And then the other planets. Not that big. There's a sun. But that's it, right? Wait, there's things bigger than a sun? No way. How is this possible? Well, I can tell you that my mind is officially blown. I wish there was just some other way for me to realize just how small we are. I wish.
I guess I'll never realize how big the universe is and how small we are. It's too bad. I guess I should just be heading out. Wait a minute. Kids, can you excuse me 1 second while I panic? Thank you. Why am I so small? Why is everything so big? Why do I sound like a chipmunk? Oh no, this is awful. What's gonna happen to me? Am I gonna get smushed? Crushed? Polarized? This is so bad.
Carl?
Jada! Thank goodness you're here! I need your help!
Why do you sound like a cartoon elf?
I'm small, Jada!
Huh?
I'm small! I shrunk myself somehow!
Oh? That's not good. How did that happen?
I don't know! 1 second I was wishing I knew how small I truly was, and then bam, here I am!
Aw, well, that stinks. Would it help if I told you about our story today?
I don't know, Jada!
Hey, don't get short with me.
I should be mad at you for that comment, but I'll let it slide. So what's the story about?
Today, we will be telling the story of Job.
It's pronounced Job.
I'm pretty sure it's Job.
Hey, potato, potato.
Anyways, kids, Job is a man who lived a long time ago, long before Jesus came to earth. Now, what made Job so special is that he had many things, a family, land, friends, livestock, and on top of all of that, Job was a very righteous man.
Righteous?
It means someone who loved God and lived for God, always doing what's right. Now, even though Job was a righteous man, there was some that thought Job was only righteous because God had given him so much.
Well, is that true?
Of course not, but little did Job know that there would be some tough times ahead of him.
Oh, like a paper cut.
Not exactly.
Like a bug in a cereal?
Little bit more than that. You see, Job was about to have his whole life turned upside down. Job was going to face many struggles that would definitely push him farther than he has ever been pushed before.
Wowza.
So Job was living his normal life when he had suddenly got very sick.
Sick?
Very sick. He had sores all over his body, then his animals were taken from him, and even some of his family had passed away.
That is awful.
It sure was. Job was having so many things taken away from him, and...
And he quit.
What?
He quit, right? He quit being righteous?
Why would you say that?
I mean, he had a great life before. Everything was great. That means it's easy to do the right thing. But if all that stuff leaves, he quits being righteous, right?
Well, that's what most people would expect. Even his wife was wondering why Job would still worship God.
I bet it was so hard to see Job suffer so much, huh?
For sure. Some of the worst things imaginable have become a reality for Job. But what's his reaction? To still worship God. You may be wondering why that is. Why would Job still worship God if almost everything in his life was taken from him? The answer is simple. Job loved God, and Job understood that God would never spiral out of control, even if everything else is falling apart. See, God made everything. The animals, the mountains, the moon, stars, even all the things and people in Job's life. He was thankful just knowing that such a big God would know him and care about him. Everything he had was thanks to God. So even if he lost everything valuable, he would still have God, which was worth more than anything or anyone. Job could see the bigness of God, which made his smallness feel a lot better.
So we're all pretty small, huh?
Yeah, some of us more than others.
Easy.
I'm just saying, Carl, there's beauty in knowing how small we are and just how big and powerful God really is.
I guess you're right. Maybe it is a good thing I got shrunk down to this size. You know, like a teenage hamster.
Really? Why?
I don't know. It kind of gave me perspiration.
Huh?
Perspection.
Do you mean perspective?
Yeah, that's what I said. It gave me perspective and helped me realize that there are so many things that God is in control of than I can imagine. And we are just an itty bitty part of what God plans. But I'm grateful I'm a part of it at all.
Well, Carl, I couldn't agree more.
Hey kids, today's big idea is a big one. You ready to hear it? Our big idea is we are small, but God is big. Let's say it out loud on the count of three. You ready? 1, 2, 3. We are small, but God is big. Great job, everybody. Now, I don't know about you, but I can't wait to hear what happens with Job. So make sure to tune in next week to Grow TV.
That's right. See you next week, kids. Also, how are we going to fix this whole thing? I'm small. I don't know how to fix this. Do I say bang a baka boogoo? Do I grow up? Do I get big again? I don't know. I guess I'm just small forever. But that's cool, because then I can like ride in people's pockets. Never have to rely on public transportation again. Rely on friendship transportation. Pockets.
So we heard from Carl about how large these planets really are, especially compared to the Earth, and how big the stars are. So I thought it'd be cool to take this idea of size to a whole nother level. And so I want to talk about the distance between each of these planets. So look at the distance between them all, and we're going to use a very special tool to use this. We're going to do toilet paper, something we all use, something very important. And we're going to use this to create a model of our solar system, but on a miniature level. All right, so this is going to be our sun. All right, nice big sun. And we're gonna use the toilet paper to measure it. So, very important to note, since this is a miniature size, each one of these little pieces of the toilet paper is going to represent 20 million kilometers in distance, all right? So to give you an idea of how much that is, the Earth, all the way around the Earth, is 40,000 kilometers. So 20 million is a lot more. That just shows how big the distance between these planets are. All right, let's get to it. It's amazing to see just how many millions and millions of kilometers these planets are from each other. Remember how many kilometers each one represented? It was 20 million. You see how long these are? That is amazing, just to see how huge our solar system is. But it's even more amazing to think how big our universe is. And it paints a big, great picture about how big and powerful God is. Because if we can get hung up on how large it is, because it's hard for us to really comprehend in our minds, just because something that big is really too much for our minds, but it gives a picture as to the infinite powerful God that we have, who's with us in our lives. Remember our big idea? It says, we are small, but our God is big. When we're overwhelmed with the things that we're going through, when things seem really hard, when our problems seem so big, we can remember that our problems are so small compared to the power that God has. And that God is on our side and helping us every step of the way. And we can trust in Him.
So, since we've started a new series, that means we get to learn a new memory verse for the series. It comes from Job 37:5. Are you ready? It says, God's voice thunders in marvelous ways. He does great things beyond our understanding. So, you're just probably asking, Ms. Ryan, how am I going to remember that? Well, we are going to learn it in sign language. Are you ready? So, it says, God's voice thunders in marvelous ways. He does great things beyond our understanding. You got that? All right, let's do it one more time all together. From Job 37:5. God's voice thunders in marvelous ways. He does great things beyond our understanding. Good job. Now it's time for you to practice.
Okay, so I'm gonna play a joke on Pastor Sonia. I asked Mr. Isaiah to go get her and tell her that I needed help, which I do with the scripture teach, we're supposed to do it, but I'm gonna ask for help with opening this can of nuts. That's really not a can of nuts. Wait till you see what happens, it'll be funny. She should be here any minute.
Hey, Miss Patty. Oh,
hey.
I heard that you needed help today.
Yeah, I did. I'm having a hard time opening this can of nuts. Can you help me with it?
I think so.
Okay, it's a little hard. It's a little stuck.
Okay, mixed nuts. Do we get to snack on them once I get them open?
I think so.
Okay.
That was so funny!
Miss Patty!
Oh, it was so funny! You should have seen your face. You were like,
oh, my goodness.
Okay, yeah, so this is not... Okay.
Okay.
I didn't know there would be three in there.
I didn't either.
One.
Well, I thought there were
going to
be peanuts.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to try this, but... Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. It's a little harder than I thought it was. It's kind of fun, though.
Yeah,
isn't it? Here,
one.
Okay. Thank
hold
you.
That. Let me go get the
I'll
other.
I'll hold it. I'll hold it. Ha ha ha. That was really funny. Okay. We should try this later.
Yes, seriously, maybe
on Isaiah.
Maybe we could. Well,
what?
He's probably around and watching.
Oh, that would not be good then.
No,
but
he
somebody
probably
else.
Knows. Yeah, we'll find somebody.
Pastor Mark.
Take it into the office.
That would be funny. Okay. It was hard to do, not impossible. But maybe we can use this later. But you know, as we were squishing this down, trying to fit everything in there, I was thinking sometimes that's what we do with God. We try to squish him down and make him make sense to us, like how we understand him. We're like, oh, this must be the way that God is. Yeah. And so we squish him down and make him limited. I mean, think about it. If you never had to sleep again, that would be cool. If you never had to sleep again and you were up 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and you would be praying.
Be
asleep. Yeah. You would be praying the entire time or worshiping.
Yeah.
Or reading the Bible. It really doesn't matter, because even at the end of that, when you come to the end of your life, you still wouldn't know everything there is to know about God, because he is way too big.
Absolutely.
And when we limit God and we squish him into our own understanding, when we're like, oh, I totally know this is how God is going to answer this question, or I know he will answer the prayers this way, or I know what God will and will not do, at some point you really begin to get arrogant, because you're like, oh, I totally have figured God out. But on top of that, you limit your faith in God, because you've made him really tiny.
Right.
Because he fits in this little square box that you created.
Right.
But that's not the way God is. You just cannot understand him, because he's way too big.
Exactly.
So there's a scripture I wanted to read.
Okay, awesome.
Isaiah chapter 40, verses 27 through 29. So go ahead and get your Bibles, and I'm going to read it right here from my paper. So here it is. It says, O Jacob, how can you say the Lord does not see your troubles? O Israel, how can you say God ignores your rights? Have you never heard? Have you never understood? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of all the earth. He never grows weak or weary. No one can measure the depths of his understanding. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless.
Right.
Isn't that amazing?
That's amazing. And you know, there's really like three characteristics of God we can learn from this and from the story of Job that we want to talk about today. Mm-hmm. And the first one I thought of as you were talking to was that God is awe-inspiring and he's majestic. He is limitless. And just like you were saying, you know, we try to put him into this box. We try to make him fit our understanding, the way we think as humans. And that's just not God. He thinks, even it's so amazing to try to comprehend how he, you know, comes about healing some and not others, and how he works some things out for people and some other people struggle, or, you know, just anything about it. We think, why does that work the way it does? But that's us trying to put God in our box. And that's what really Job was doing.
Yeah.
Job was trying to get answers from God. Yeah. Why is this happening to me? Why do I have to go through this?
Yeah.
And he wanted God to tell him why, but God wasn't going to reveal that.
Yeah.
It was more about Job beginning to trust.
Yeah, yeah. So, and we know that we can trust God, right? Because he is all-knowing and all-powerful, right? Because God wants us to trust him, because he knows more than we do. And so since he is all-knowing and all-powerful, we know that we can put our trust in him. And that's what he was asking Job to do. He was asking Job to trust him, to believe that he had his back. And even though he wasn't going to explain things, in the end, what he wanted Job to understand was, I'm faithful. What we need to understand, God is faithful. Despite what's going on, he is faithful.
Right. Mm-hmm. And so the third thing we want to talk about from this is that, you know, God is tremendously, the word I like to use is ginormous.
He uses it a lot.
Yeah, I do use that word a lot. He's huge. He's big. Here's the picture I have. I have God's hands like this, and us as little humans in his hands. We are so very small compared to God, but I think that is a wonderful view of God, because when we don't understand, it's like we can just crawl up into his hands and allow him to take care of us.
Yeah.
With Job, you know, even when prior to all of this happening with Job, things were going great for Job, and and all, you know, he had gained wealth and he had a large family and he was well known and respected in the community, and things were going good. And Job very much could have just said, well, I got it all together.
Yeah.
You know, I'm set, I'm good, I know how to do life.
Mm-hmm.
But he didn't. He still trusted God. He still knew that God was his creator, his maker, and that God was his provider and had basically given Job all that he had up to that point. And that's really what, you know, carried him through all the struggles that he went through, was that foundation of faith and trust that he had in God, even in those times of questioning. And when things got really, really difficult, Job knew to trust in God. He knew to crawl up into the hands of God and let God carry him.
Yep.
And so we're going to pray today.
Okay.
And really what we want to pray about is that we would have that same type of trust and faith that Job did. That when things seem crazy and when they seem so big and we are so small, that we can trust God. Because, you know, none of us like to feel small.
No.
We don't want to feel like we're the smallest person, or we know the least, or, you know, oh, poor, pitiful me, and nobody really knows, I'm just like in the corner. Nobody likes to feel that way. But we can trust that when we're feeling that way, God sees us.
Yeah.
God knows. He knew Job. He knew what Job was going through. And Job could trust God. And so that's what that's the kind of trust that we need to have. So that's what we're going to pray about today. Mm-hmm. So I want you to close your eyes and bow your heads, and let's go to God in prayer right now. Father, we do thank you, God, that you know each of us, God, and that while we may feel small at times, God, we know that that is a great place to be, because that means that you are a big God and that you see us and know us and can take care of every part of us, God. Not including all the other people around us, God, that you see each of us. And that when we do feel that way, we can trust you, God. And that's really what we need to do, is we need to put our full faith and trust in you, knowing that you are going to take care of all of our needs, whatever it is that we are walking through. So for all of our kids and adults that are watching right now, God, I pray, Father, that in this moment, they would just rest in you. They would take that mental picture of crawling up into your hands and letting you comfort them and carry them and surround them, Father God. And that in that they can trust that you will work out everything for their good, Father. We love you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
So, Miss Patty, I think we need to take your can and go find somebody to give it to.
Sounds good to me.
So we always want to help you understand how this lesson applies in your life. So I have some friends here who are going to help me, and I have a bucket full of paper. So what we're going to do is we have statements in here, and you are going to decide whether the statement is big thinking or little thinking.
Okay.
So big thinking is when you're trying to understand things in the way that God wants you to.
Okay.
And then little thinking is when you're trying to understand something that only a human can see, like understand.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so if it's big thinking, I want you to place the statement inside the orca's mouth.
Okay.
And if it's a little thinking, small thinking, you're going to place it inside the little tiny dolphin's mouth.
All right. Do they bite?
I hope not, because I just pet it.
Oh.
If you're not nice to them, maybe they will.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay,
who
are you guys ready?
First? Yeah.
Who wants to go first?
You can go first.
I'll go first.
Okay.
Okay.
The universe is so big and complicated, there will always be more things to discover.
I think that's true.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, that is true.
So like, is that a big thing or a little thing?
I think it's a big thing.
Pretty big thing.
I think so.
Definitely.
Oh, that was fun. You almost fell.
That's not very nice.
No, it wasn't. I'm
that's
sorry.
That's little thinking.
That was good. That was good.
Okay. Being small helps me know how much I need God's help.
Ooh.
That's true.
That's a really big thinking.
I think that's big.
Yeah.
There you
go.
Yeah. All right.
I agree with that one.
All right. Let's see what we got next here. All right. The situation feels so hard. If God really loved me, he would fix it. I don't know if that's the right attitude, because sometimes difficult situations help us to grow and to learn more about God and create his character too. So when God doesn't work for us, God will definitely help us through every situation, but he doesn't, you know, promise that every bad situation won't happen. Right. So I'm gonna say that's a small
thinking. I agree. I think that's small. Okay.
Fold that up and put it in there
small.
For
our girlfriend. Make it small.
Make it small. This is kind of fun. I have been going to church all my life. I've got God figured out.
That person must be the smartest person in the entire world.
For real.
The only person that can figure out God is God.
No one can figure out God. I don't think.
We learn new things every day about him.
All the time.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's little thinking.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Very little thinking.
Okay. I am so good. It's true. I have all the answers.
Do you?
No, I think this sounds really small. We're going to put
him
right there.
That's not big thinking. All right, here we go.
Nope.
All right. The Bible is pretty confusing. I need help to understand it. I don't know if that's, big or, I guess that's big thinking, because if you're not sure, you can ask somebody to help you understand it. So there are some things that are pretty confusing in the Bible.
It's like what we were saying with the person who thinks they have God all figured out. Like, we don't, got the Bible is God's words, and
this person doesn't think they have it all figured out. That's true.
Being small means I'm not important.
Oh.
Ooh.
I don't think that's true.
Me neither. Mm-hmm.
I guess we're all small compared to God.
Compared to God, everyone's small.
Yeah, everyone's tiny. Small. So I don't think that means we're unimportant. We're very important to him.
I think so, yeah. I didn't like that one.
No.
Here we go. This is what I think, so you must be wrong.
Wow.
Have you ever had somebody say that to you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's gotta be so small.
Yes.
Oh my goodness, you do not know everything.
No, we don't know everything. And everyone has their own opinion, so.
They do.
All right, there we go. I trust God more than I trust my feelings because he is bigger. That's definitely big thinking
there. It's right in
there.
Yeah,
bigger. Yeah.
Bigger, big. It's big thinking.
Yeah.
He is, definitely. He's way bigger. Like we said before, he's bigger than us.
Mm-hmm. And your feelings aren't always accurate.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, is the last one. Can I read it?
Yeah, your turn.
I'll get the bucket for you.
Yay. So, this one says, I do not like this situation at all, but I know God is with me.
Oh, that's good. That's good. That attitude.
Yeah, that's definitely big thinking.
I like this one. That's good to end out.
Yeah.
God is a good way to end. No matter what you are doing, even if you are having a hard time, he is always going to be there with you. He is not going to leave you alone. Mm-hmm. Even when you don't feel like he's there, he's there.
That sounds good.
Definitely.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
So, yay. So, thank you so much, guys, for helping us with this. Because I was having a hard time with this big thinking, little thinking. So, you guys definitely helped me out.
Hey, I can't wait to start this game.
Yes, it's great.
I'm going to beat you.
I will see about that. Wow, man, this is going to be great.
What color do you want to be?
Ooh, definitely green.
Okay.
Green,
I like the pinky purple. What?
Isaiah, Miss Patty, I have a different game for you to play. A different Connect Four. I'll be right back.
How do you do Connect Four in different?
I don't understand. This is the whole big, small thing.
Yeah, I mean, we got a big
version, right?
We're
playing the big stuff. This is going to be so much fun.
This is what you're going to play.
What?
This version of Connect Four.
What? It's so tiny.
Do you have tweezers for this?
I'm gonna have to pull out my glasses.
All right.
So that I can see.
Here you go. I'm still gonna win. All right. I guess I'll be orange. Really.
Okay.
All right.
Do you wanna go first?
You go first.
All right. Thank you. Well, you can't even see mine. There you go. Block you.
That was rude.
Yeah, I know. I really like being rude. Well, now you blocked me. That was rude. Oh, you have shenanigans? I'm afraid. Don't you try to outsmart me. Don't
Don't use logic on me. It doesn't work. You would never use logic? Okay, good for you. I see what you're up to. I'm blocking you. I see what you're up to. If I put one in there, you're gonna have that not gonna happen. And then you could go there too, not gonna happen. How can, I just feel like I'm offensive here. Oh, that's funny, I'm offensive. I mean, I'm on the offense. I'm not offensive. Okay, we have to stop that. You won anyway! Oh, that's disheartening.
Don't worry, you might win if we play five more times.
That's so kind of you.
I'm kidding, you did pretty. Well, that's the big finish for this first lesson in our series, Big and Small. Hope you enjoyed it, and please join us next week for another lesson video. Also, like, share, and subscribe for all our videos, and make sure you share them with your friends so we can get this message out there to as many people as possible. Hope to see you next time. Bye.